Hi friends, so far we have discussed about safety leadership, safety culture, importance of understanding safety before leading. Now we are going to discuss on very unique topic, safe decision making and cognitive bias. As all of you know that safe decision play a critical role in performance, but decision is undermined by cognitive bias. Let's quickly go through content. We will know what is cognitive bias. We will know how we always fail to consider baseline and why using mental shortcut while estimating risk. We will also know type of cognitive bias. We will also try to understand different type of bias through some example. So let's try to understand cognitive bias. Cognitive bias are not a mistake or an error, but they are chronic way of thinking that produce inaccurate judgment. Safe decision making are critically important at all level. You can understand with example, it is not good if I decide not to wear seatbelt in my car I am driving, but it will be disaster if I decide not to equip company vehicle with seatbelt. In this session, we will explore role of cognitive bias and how they affect judgment and decision about safety. Now come to cognitive bias while estimating risk. While estimating risk, actually we make judgment about a probability. For example, is it good idea for my daughter to start driving a car at the age of 16? How do I go about making this important decision? I want her to learn car driving, but is she ready to start now? Probably I make that decision based on my assessment of my daughter maturity level. Now question is she emotionally stable? Does she have ability to pay attention? Is she overly influenced by her peers? If I come to conclusion that she is mature enough, I tend to think driving is okay. In fact, thinking about it is this way, this is fall to victim in cognitive bias. Before I consider all stuff, what is baseline of accident frequency of this age group? So bias is called failure to consider baseline. We always use mental shortcut while estimating risk. Now come to overconfidence bias and underestimating risk. Now question to all of you. How good driver are you? Compared to other driver on road, are you above average or below average? It's a human nature to overestimate their skill and ability. Maintaining positive view of ourselves help us to cope with adversity and help us to thrive. But unfortunately, it also causes to make a poor judgment about risk. Psychologists call it as a overconfidence bias. There are some statements of overconfidence bias like I understand safety as well as our safety people do. Our safety system are first rate. We have not had fatality in last 3 years. This training does not apply to me. We have done it like this for 30 years and I have not been injured. That would not happen to me. So all these are example of non-confidence bias. Overconfidence bias. One way to detect bias is by listening to your thoughts and to what people around you say. The first step to overcoming overconfidence bias is to teach people about it. Let's discuss on second type of bias, availability bias, and investing time and money in safety. Availability bias is tendency to give too much weight to the information that is readily available. Let's try to understand with example. Most of us have experience an urgency to improve when injury rates are high. People respond to urgency by shifting resource and attention, which are usually effective in bringing injury rate down again, at least temporarily. As the injury rate down, urgency fades, attention and issue resurface that bring injury rate back. Unless we have system in place to help maintain consistent focus and attention. Availability bias focus of last thing that happened. Let's discuss a third type of bias called confirmation bias and pre-task assessment. Confirmation bias is tendency to search for, interpret, favor, recall information that confirm and support one prior personal belief or values. Let's try to understand it with example. Several years ago, miner with 30 years of experience died when roof of tunnel had been collapsed. Before starting work, he and foreman inspected tunnel roof structure and found none. After an incident, investigation happened in which 137 missing bolt and compromised roof plank were identified. Now question is, had they seen risk but convinced themselves nothing bad would happen them that day? Had they just not expected to find any problem during their pre-task assessment? People tend to look what they know and find what they expect. So this is all about safe decision making and cognitive bias. Hope you have enjoyed this session. Thank you and have a safe day.